Live from the Clark Athletic Center Gymnasium, this is another production of the Beacons Broadcast Network as UMass Boston hosts Eastern Nazarene College on a Saturday afternoon on the campus of UMass Boston. It's the 30th annual Harbor Invitational here in Boston. The Beacons looking to come away with a victory after an impressive win yesterday over the College of St. Joseph's. The same can be said, though, for Eastern Nazarene. They had maybe a program-defining win, taking down Colby College 74-68 yesterday. And as you can see, both of these teams enter today's final with an undefeated record. Let's check out their statistics so far this season. We're looking for what could be a very high-scoring affair. You see both of these teams average over 84 points a game. Certainly impressive in that regard. And we'll also take a look at who's been leading these two teams to victory to start this season. Carl Joseph, certainly the man of the season so far for UMass Boston, averaging 24 points a game so far. Gregory Young has been a huge help as well for UMass Boston. And you got Carl Aguinor, who's been maybe one of the best rebounding forwards that we've seen in many years under the reign of Charlie Titus for UMass Boston. As for Eastern Nazarene, you can see their offense is led by Jalen Owens. He led the team and played all 40 minutes in yesterday's win, scored 20 points, pulled down 7 rebounds, handed out 5 assists, and stole 6 balls to create a lot of turnovers for the victorious Lions yesterday. He'll be a player to watch, but for the Beacons, we're keeping an eye on number 23, Luke Ulysses, the transfer from Roxbury Community College. Had an interesting game yesterday for UMass Boston. 3 of 5 three-point shooting, so he certainly had the range from beyond the arc, but once he stepped inside the three-point line, Ulysses shot 1 of 9, so you can see the three ball has been there for Luke. We'll see if he can make some more consistent shots from inside the three-point line, but the Beacons have certainly appreciated what he's been able to do from downtown so far this season. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the Eastern Nazarene Lions. You can see it on your screen in just a minute as Eric Lynch, Jalen Owens, Jeremy Wagner, his twin brother Justin Wagner, and Alex Jarman comprise the starting five for Eastern Nazarene. And as you can see, they've got 4 guards, really a 4-out formation for them, just one big man down low, Alex Jarman, and he clocks in for the Lions. Pretty big guy, but he's not going to overpower you as he stands at 6'5 from Portsmouth, Rhode Island. He's the senior. They also have Eddie Ramirez on the roster. He's a junior, 6'6 from Clovis, California. He should come in off the bench for the Lions. Now let's check out UMass Boston starting lineups. No changes here. It's been the same starting five all season long. This is now the 6th consecutive game that we've seen Medina, Ulysses, Young, Joseph, and McGuire out there for Charlie Titus's squad. But of course, you got to keep in mind, Carl Aguinor has come off the bench lately and actually produced starters minutes in yesterday's win over St. Joseph's College. You saw Aguinor get out there and play 27 minutes, and he's averaged around 27 and a half minutes off the bench this season. Very impressive stuff for him, especially rebounding the basketball. That's going to lead us into our keys to the game. It's the size advantage for UMass Boston. They don't usually have it, but we talked about the one big man down low, at least in the starting lineup for Eastern Nazarene, Alex Jarman, who did have 13 points and 9 rebounds with 5 blocks yesterday. But the Beacons have a ton of size, at least compared to the Lions. Carl Joseph has certainly been a factor down low, and Carl Aguinor as well. Now, in terms of Eastern Nazarene's go-to offensive strategies, they do like to drive. They have 2 different left-handed drivers. Corey Durant can certainly slash inside. Then you've got the twin tandem of Jeremy and Justin Wagner. Now, Jeremy Wagner was very good from downtown yesterday, 2 for 2 from three-point range, and his twin brother Justin Wagner is shooting 45% from downtown this season, so a pretty good combination of penetration and outside shooting for the Lions, so they'll certainly want to keep an eye on that as the starting lineups are being introduced here for both teams by today's PA man and sports information director, Dave Wahlberg. Just about ready for the opening tip-off. My name is Tyler Murray. Thanks for being with us. Jose Pena is our director. Charles Lai is the cameraman for the final of the Harbor Invitational. And in just about an hour, we're going to kick off our second broadcast of the day, a 4 o'clock puck drop for the women's hockey team hosting Colby College in a pretty impressive matchup between two teams who have shown some talent early on in the season, so don't forget to check that game out at 4 p.m. But for now, it's time for Beacons basketball. It'll be Carl Joseph taking the opening tip for UMass Boston, going left to right across your screen in the blue and white, and the tip is won by the Lions, pulled down after he won the tip by Alex Jarman. So here we go. It was a 74-68 win for Eastern Nazarene yesterday over Colby College to get them into this final championship game of the Harbor Invitational. The 30th time it's been put on by UMass Boston. At the free throw line, Eric Lynch gets inside around Joseph and in with the left hand. Early 2-0 lead for Eastern Nazarene. Eric Lynch, the junior guard from Alpharetta, Georgia, played his high school ball at Centennial High. Ulysses comes around the near side to his point guard, Leo Medina. Gets a pick from Joseph at the free throw line. Thought about taking a shot, but kicks it out to McGuire instead. Now Ulysses down low to Medina. Still 15 seconds to shoot for UMass Boston. Top of the key, Joseph to the near side wing, Ulysses. Dribble drive and a dish out to Joseph once again. Leaves one for Gregory Young, who had a huge game last night. Drives toward the baseline right hand, finds some room inside, and finishes off the window. Good answer there from Young, the senior from Dorchester, Mass. 18 points last night, 7 rebounds, 6 assists, and 4 blocks. He really does it all for UMass Boston. Defending Justin Wagner now, gets it to his twin brother, Jeremy. Both 5'9", or 5'10", rather, guards from Oklahoma City. Now this is Jeremy, defended by Ulysses. Gets it back towards the center court logo for Jalen Owens, who, as we said in the pregame show, played all 40 minutes last night and it went over Colby College, but now he's stripped. Medina comes away with it all the way coast to coast. He got fouled, or did he? He pushed off with his non-shooting hand. Offensive foul is the call. And Eastern Nazarene gets possession. Well, a good job by Medina to force the steal and get himself a breakaway scoring opportunity, but give credit to Jalen Owen staying with the play and drawing that offensive foul. Here's Jeremy Wagner, right back to Owens, a long three, rattles home. Close to NBA range there from the right wing. It's a 5-2 Eastern Nazarene lead. To the corner for an open Stephen McGuire, down low for Gregory Young, using that size to find space for Medina from the corner, too short, off the front rim. Up ahead to Jalen Owens, one-on-one with Ulysses, fights through contact and puts it in. 7-2, a 5-point cushion for the Lions, as Owen sprinted out to the open court off of the miss. This is McGuire. Joseph swings to Medina. Leo, the junior from Brockton, Massachusetts. They free up Ulysses. Pump fake, dribble drive, Euro step inside. He got fouled. And two free throws upcoming. Well, we talked about it in the pregame show. Luke Ulysses was able to knock down 3 of his 5 3-point attempts yesterday, but otherwise went just 1-for-9 from the field. And that time he used his three-point reputation to throw a good pump fake up and found some space inside. He knocks this first free throw through, shooting 75% this season from the charity stripe. 11 points last night, and overall shooting 42% from downtown. He goes 1-of-2 from the line as Justin Wagner pulls down the rebound and finds Jalen Owens to Jeremy Wagner, up to Eric Lynch, and now Owens can reset. About 2.5 minutes gone through in this one. Owens directing traffic. Goes to the near side. This is Jeremy Wagner off the side rim, and Ulysses pulls down the board. Quickly gets it to Medina across the timeline. Up top, Ulysses all the way around for McGuire, and now down low to Young. Gets double teamed momentarily. This frees up Stephen McGuire, who rainbows one off the backboard. The senior from Rancho Cucamonga, California, comes up empty and puts a foul on a streaking Alex Jarman on the other end. Should be 2 free throws for the big man. McGuire starting his 6th game of the season, averaging a little under 7 points a game, but shooting 52% from the field. Here comes a free throw from Alex Jarman, shooting 54.5% from the line this year. Can't get the roll this time. 7-3 is the score. UMass Boston had a free throw put home by Luke Ulysses. Gregory Young drove in for a baseline layup to get them on the board to start things. McGuire in transition, back out to Medina. Ulysses flashed toward the top, but that frees up an elbow jumper for Medina, but he misses. He's 0-for-2 from the field, and the rebound goes to the Lions, where Justin Wagner picks up and finds his point guard, Jalen Owens. Justin goes down to Jeremy. There's a dribble drive from Alex Jarman. Nice pass inside. A block from behind. Ulysses knocks it away from Lynch. And here comes Luke back the other way. To the far wing. This is Young. Can't get the roll in and out. But the loose ball comes out to Ulysses. He drives in and finishes. He's got three of the Beacon's first 5 points. And give credit to Stephen McGuire tipping that ball back to Ulysses. An offensive rebound for him. Carl Aguinar is ready at the scorer's table, hoping to check in soon. 16 minutes to go in the first half. It's 7-5 in favor of the Lions. This is Wagner. Pump fakes, gets Young out of his way, goes to his brother in the corner. A whistle before the shot. 3-second violation on Eastern Nazarene, so the Beacons take over, and Aguinar will come in for McGuire. Carl Aguinar, the junior from Dorchester, Massachusetts, had another double-double last night. 12 points, 14 rebounds. He's been a big factor since transferring from Wake Technical Community College in Raleigh, North Carolina before this season. He's got the ball right away down low, fights through contact and softly puts it through. Two quick points for Carl Aguinar, and it's a tie ball game, 7-7. Owens gets a pick, another NBA range three ball, rattles out. He knocked one down earlier but couldn't get the roll this time. Gets it right back, a good offensive rebound fought for by Eric Lynch in the paint. A rare sight. Carl Aguinar out-hustled for a board. Won't see that too much more if you've gotten used to Beacon's basketball this season, as it goes up to Jeremy Wagner. Fresh shot clock, of course. He finds his brother, Justin. Backdoor cut by Owens, but Wagner couldn't find him. Now he does at the NCAA logo. Owens cuts inside, lost the handle, still loose. 3 seconds to shoot. Wild shot. Wagner's way off and is boarded by Aguinar. He finds Medina. Beacons can take their first lead of the game. Into the corner. Luke Ulysses open for three. He knocks it down. Luke's got 6 points on the afternoon, and the Beacons take their first lead of the day. 10-7 the score. Heading toward the scorer's table to check in soon to Amaris Benford. At the low block, Eric Lynch hop steps inside, but Joseph denies. And back come the Beacons. This is Medina in transition. Top of the key for Young. A pump fake. Down low to Aguinar, but a charge called. Offensive foul on Gregory Young. Pretty impressive reaction time down there in the paint by Eastern Nazarene to take the hit. It's actually Corey Doran coming in. 11 points off the bench for him yesterday. The junior from Fairfield, California, stands at 6'4". Far wing for Jalen Owens. Gets a pick down low to Duran. Intercepted by Joseph. He had a block a couple possessions ago. And another turnover forced by the senior. Bounce pass to the corner for Ulysses, but it spins out of his hands. And the Lions take possession once again. Jalen Owens averaging 22 points a game to lead the Lions. Shooting 38.5% from downtown. Duran at the elbow, defended by Joseph, forces his way inside, kicks out to Justin Wagner. Now this is Jeremy Wagner. Owens defended by Medina. Beacons lead by 3, 13.5 minutes to go in the opening half in the Harbor Invitational final round. Wagner down low for Duran. It goes off the bottom of the rim off a deflection, and Aguinar comes away with the steal. This is Medina. A pick from Joseph, pulls back, finds Carl. His first field goal attempt of the afternoon won't go. Young pulls down the rebound. That one couldn't find the twine, but Aguinar is there to follow, and Carl gets his 4th point of the day. A couple of point-blank layups for Carl, and Aguinar has been able to have a very impressive field goal percentage this year, 42% for him, as the Beacons come away with another steal. This is Young up to Medina. Leo's got plenty of space. Finger roll inside won't go off the back rim, but Aguilar once again pulls down a board. Near side wing, this is Gregory Young, but he can't get it to go off the front rim. And it's pulled down by Owens. A timeout called by Eastern Nazarene. Jim Aller is the head coach in his sixth season. He wants to talk things over. UMass Boston was down 7-2, but they've gone on a 10-0 run to get themselves a five-point lead. We'll take a quick break and come back with more Beacons basketball on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Twelve minutes, 43 seconds to go in the first half. UMass Boston leads it 12-7. Off the timeout, Eastern Nazarene will put Christian Lynch out there with Owens. And now there's only one Wagner twin out there. It's Justin. He finds Owens in the corner. Got plenty of room for that three ball, and he puts it home. Second long ball Owens has sunk this afternoon. He's got 6 points. 2 for 3 from downtown. Medina up top to Young, thought about a three but took one dribble and picked it up instead right into the free throw line. Around to Joseph, they find Luke Ulysses, got tangled up there with Lynch. Loose ball in Beacon territory, picked up by Duran and he puts it home, plus the foul. Carl Joseph did well to pursue that play, but he couldn't keep the ball away from Corey Duran, who puts it home, and a free throw could give Eastern Nazarene the lead right back. We told you Doran had 11 points off the bench in yesterday's win, making an impact already here for Eastern Nazarene. That time he can't get the free throw to go. So Gregory Young finds Medina. They swing it all the way around to Ulysses. Left-hand dribble drive inside. Reverse layup won't go. Ulysses, much like yesterday, has the range from downtown, but couldn't quite finish there. But a good move to find some space underneath the basket. Owens, trigger happy, and why not? His third three-point shot this afternoon. That could be a big factor for Eastern Nazarene today. Gregory Young wants to answer. Bounce pass to Ulysses. His three-ball attempt very short. Picked up by Medina. Spin move inside. Off the back rim, no good. It's pulled down by Alex Jarman, who finds Owens. All the way back near side for Wagner. Towards the baseline, this is Doran. Bounce pass to the other corner. Picked up by Lynch. Pump fakes to get rid of Medina, but his open jump shot won't go. And the rebound goes to UMass Boston. Carl Aguilar pulls down another. Beacons trail by three all of a sudden, mostly because of the hot shooting of Jalen Owens. But there's Joseph to respond. His first points of the afternoon. Carl Joseph closing in on 1,000 points, 29 yesterday. He actually scored 15 of the Beacon's first 20 points. So far today, though, he's been contributing in other ways. As the score is evened up for a moment, Owens with a heat check. That wouldn't go from the similar spot. He's been stroking the threes already in this first half. The Beacons can take the lead here. Aguilar gets fancy on the dribble, but maybe a bit too fancy. He took a step or two, and that's going to be a traveling violation. Now Medina will hit the bench as Omar Benavicia comes in, the junior guard from Saugus, Massachusetts. Beacons again in the blue and white uniforms going left to right while the Eastern Nazarene Lions take the ball up in the red, black, and white unis. To Doran at the elbow, turns and faces on Joseph, wants to take it inside, can't get the roll. Aguilar rips down the board and gets it up to Benavicia. Omar on the move, he finds Aguilar. Now Ulysses, bounce pass inside to Joseph, finds space, adjusts in midair, can't get it to go. Rebound by Aguilar, he has it stripped away. And it goes back to the Beacons. Joseph picks off the outlet pass, Young inside, finishes strong. And UMass Boston is up 17-15. Gregory Young has 4 points. Doran kick out, Wagner a quick three, rushed that one. and got nothing. But Aguilar can't pull down the rebound cleanly. Strong move inside from Alex Jarman, but he misses as well. So Ulysses back the other way. Beacons lead by two. Aguilar to Young. Now back to Ulysses. Joseph has some room, wants to pull the trigger, and he splashes another one home. A couple of three balls for Carl Joseph. He's shooting 37.5% from long range entering this game, and he's 2-for-2 from beyond the arc already in the final round. Owens pump fakes, finds Lynch in the corner, the left-handed shot off the backboard, and it's taken by Joseph. 20-15, UMass Boston. As Aguilar thought about finding Benabicha, but instead goes to Joseph. Now Young gets a screen and some space near side. He puts it through. That's a three ball for Gregory Young, and he's got 7 points on the day. UMass Boston shooting very well from downtown. Entered this game with a 33.7% efficiency from beyond the arc. As Wagner looks to answer, but that one rattles out. Aguilar fights for the rebound, and Ulysses gets credit for it. Bounce pass up ahead to Young. Inside, he kicks it back out to Ulysses. Room inside, and he puts it through. Didn't get much elevation on that dribble drive, but somehow banks it home, and the Beacons quickly take a 10-point lead, 25-15 in the blink of an eye. Charlie Tuttis has to love the tempo in this one as the Beacons hope to extend their lead. Lynch on the wing, gets a pick. Not much room to get around Aguilar, though. This is Jarman on the baseline. His pass intercepted by Joseph, and the Beacons once again possess. Ulysses up ahead to Aguilar. This is Gregory Young. A long three won't go, and it's taken away by Lynch. He'll take it himself. Underhand pass to Doran. Tries to cross over, but dribbles off his foot. And look at Young getting down and dirty. He forces a steal, and now Ulysses will take the ball across the timeline, waits for Young to catch up, and now Gregory directs some traffic. Benabicha down low, Ulysses and Aguilar playing catch. Carl gets double-teamed, puts it up anyway, and comes up short. Good defense there by Lynch on the baseline. 7.5 minutes to go in the first half. Three subs set to come in for Eastern Nazarene as Alex Jarman finishes with the left hand to get the Lions back within 8 points, 25-17. The Beacons have the lead with 7 minutes and 17 seconds remaining in the first half. We'll take a quick break and get you caught up on some statistics. It's been quite impressive from long range for UMass Boston. We'll run down a couple of stats in just a bit. This is the Beacons Broadcast Network. Eight points separating these two high-tempo teams, 25-17. The Beacons in front, in large part because of their long-distance shooting. They're 4-for-9 from downtown, a couple from Joseph, and one each from Ulysses and Young. This is Carl Joseph down low to the recently inserted Salim Omerovic, trying to get physical down inside, but a good play by Eddie Ramirez just into the game breaks it up. This is Owens in transition, too strong with that layup, and it goes to Benabicha. By comparison, ENC is 3-for-9 from downtown, but all three of those have been put home by Jalen Owens, who is 3-for-5 from long distance. He gets the ball up ahead to Eric Lynch. Top of the key for Ramirez. Both he and Jarman, the only players at 6'5 and above that get regular playing time for this ENC club. This is Owens, gets a screen from Ramirez. Omerovic with that long reach, shields against the shot. Good pass inside for Ramirez, but he's too strong yet again, and Aguilar pulls it down. So a couple of inside looks in rapid succession for the Lions, but both Ramirez And Owens put it too hard off the glass. This has been a beatcha getting aggressive, but good defense on the baseline. Both Ramirez and Lynch were in on that one. This is Eric Lynch inside, scored 17 points yesterday, and he's got four in this one. 2 for 5 from the field, a rebound as well for Eric Lynch, the junior from Alpharetta, Georgia. Carl Joseph finds a cutting Benebicha, gets it right back. This is Ulysses into the corner for Omerovich, and he gets it right back to Luke. Now they'll play pick and roll. They find Omerovich down low, kick out near side, Benebicha, open three. UMass Boston 5 for 10 from downtown, and they've opened up a 9-point lead, 28-19. Christian Lynch, the sophomore, gets it into the corner for Owens, the junior. Now down low to Ramirez, a junior from Clovis, California. Good D from Omerovich, and right now those bank shots aren't quite working for Eastern Nazarene. They're averaging 84 points a game, but a slow start offensively. Omerovich gets a nice feed down low from Aguinor. Give Carl the assist, Salim puts it through. His first points of the game after just picking up his first assist. And that nice kick out to Benebicha. 11-point lead for the Beacons. The Lions swing this one around. Wagner, top of the key, lost the handle. Still plenty of time left on the shot clock. 15 seconds to be exact. Owens defended by Ulysses. Nearly over-dribbled, but regains the handle. Pull-up jump shot, well short. And that's going to be a foul down low on Eddie Ramirez. Aguinor skied for the rebound, but clearly got pushed in the back. First foul on Ramirez, and that's just the second team foul against Eastern Nazarene. The Beacons have four. Of course, seven team fouls put you in the 1-1 bonus. As you can see, Luke Ulysses taking some of the point guard responsibilities, sharing them with Omar Benavicha, with Leo Medina on the bench at the moment. Benebicha crosses over to his left hand, now finds Gregory Young in the corner. Aguinor with some room for a long ball, and why not try it with as well as the Beacons have been shooting from downtown today, but a rare miss from three as Aguinor can't find the twine. Now the Wagner's play catch. This is Justin from the corner, and he puts one through. Justin Wagner, his first points of the day. Back to an 8-point game. Now Ulysses gets trapped beyond the timeline and quickly calls a timeout to avoid a turnover. So Charlie Titus will talk things over with his team, who lead 30-22 is the score. UMass Boston in front with 3:51 to go here in the first half. A quick stat check for you. The Beacons led by Luke Ulysses, 3 for 5 from the field, including a three. Carl Joseph, a couple of long balls, 6 points for him. Gregory Young, 3 for 7 shooting. He's got 7 points. Leo Medina, as we said, was just given a breather on the bench. 0 for 4 from the field, but 3 boards and 2 assists. And Carl Aguinor, who came off the bench after 5 minutes of play or so, has 4 points and 10 rebounds. That's right. Carl Aguinor has 10 rebounds already, and we've still got about 4 minutes to go in the first half. As for Eastern Nazarene, they're led by Jalen Owens, 9 points, all on 3 balls. Eric Lynch, Patrick Michelle, Justin Wagner, Corey Doran, and Alex Jarman also have tallied points for the Lions this afternoon. Pass inside to Omerovich, knocked away by Jarman. This is Wagner from long range off the back rim. It spins out, and Omerovich gets the rebound. Now Ulysses across to Benebicha, wants to drive inside, now kicks out to Luke, who pulls back looking for a 3-ball, and not a bad idea with a zone being put on here, it seems, by Eastern Nazarene. A 2-3 to be exact, so there should be some shooting lanes for the Beacons, like that one there for Gregory Young, but he bounces one inside to Aguinor. Nice pass, Benebicha, he finishes. Omar Benebicha with 5 points today. He's been a factor off the bench. 2 for 2 from the field as well. This is Wagner again, an open three. This time he knocks it through. Justin Wagner, a couple of long-range deliveries. 6 points for him. Wagner entered this game shooting 45% from downtown, nearing his per-game average of 8.3 points per game. As we said, he already has 6. Ulysses gets a pick from Aguinor, who fades out to an open spot for 3. Puts it home. Carl Aguinor. Doesn't take a ton of long-range shots, but knocks that one down. He's one for two from beyond the arc today. This is Lynch inside. Eric Lynch kicks out to the near side. Jeremy Wagner from long range. The Wagner twins filling it up from beyond the arc. They've combined to knock down a trio of triples, and it's back to a seven-point advantage for UMass Boston. Now Young got hand-checked on his way to the basket, so it'll be an inbounds pass for the Beacons. Still just three team fouls against ENC. Leo Medina's going to come in now for Luke Ulissi. Luke was able to put 8 points on the board for the Beacons in the first 18 minutes of the half, and there's Omerovich getting crafty down low, reverse layup. Salim has 4 points. 9-point Beacon advantage. Now this is Owens from long range. Gets the bounce off the front rim, off the backboard, and in. Didn't hesitate, and the soft touch rewards him with a nice bucket. Young down low to Benabicha, and once again, Omar able to finish. 7 points for him. He's yet to miss from the field. And once again, we're seeing Gregory Young fill up that stat sheet. 2 rebounds, 3 assists as Owens once again drives inside and gets a bucket. That's his first point not scored from three-point range. He's got 11 on 4 of 8 shooting. Now Carl Aguinor screens and kicks it back out to Benabicha, who finds Medina. Leo gets a pick and sends it out towards Young. Into the corner, Omerovich thought about it, but instead they work it around to Medina. 1:05 to go in the first half. Benabicha forces up a three off the side rim. Nice rebound, though, from Young. Inside to Omerovich, all the way back around for Omar. Drives on Wagner, takes a piece of contact, and can't finish with the floater. 1:00 to go in the first half. Beacon's lead is down to 6, 39-33. Owens gets a pick, wants to drive inside. His floater won't go. Aguinor fumbled with the rebound, but he got either pushed from behind or on that floater, a foul was called on Owens' shot. We'll see what we get from the official. It was a push on the back, I believe, on Aguinor's rebound attempt, and you saw Owens waiting to pass that ball in for ENC, but the contact he took was not noticed, it would seem. Each team has 4 fouls with 40 seconds to go in the first half. 39-33, UMass Boston in front. Young finds Benabicha. Omar drives in, tries to shuffle one over to Aguinor, but it deflects out to the top of the key where Young can rework it. Medina, with 15 to shoot, swings it around towards Benabicha. On the low block, this is Young. He turns and faces, picks up his dribble. Across he goes towards Medina. 8 seconds to shoot. Leo, top of the key. Aguinor tries it again, and he puts it home. Pretty impressive range for the big fella. 10 rebounds and a couple of three balls in the first half for Carl Aguinor. 3 seconds to go in the half. Wagner has to force it up, and he can't put it home. UMass Boston will take a 9-point lead into the locker room. 42-33, they lead this one at halftime, as the Beacons' long-range accuracy made the difference in the opening stanza. To be exact, they were able to knock down an astonishing 6 long balls in 13 tries, 46.2% from downtown. Aguinor was able to hit 2, as we said. Joseph knocked down a pair. Ulissi, Benabicha, and Young also hit triples as well. Very balanced scoring for UMass Boston, as Ulissi leads the way with 8 points, but 3 different Beacons have 7-plus, Young, Benabicha, and Aguinor. They've also got contributions from Omerovich, Joseph, McGuire, and really Benabicha's emergence off the bench both yesterday and here today have given the Beacons a much-needed boost as they're searching for a 6-0 start, hoping to continue their best opening to a season since 1997. As for Eastern Nazarene, Jalen Owens leads them and all scorers with 14 points, 5 for 9 from the field, and 4 of 6 from long range. We haven't seen Owens too much aside from today and yesterday, but always going to be tough for any player to continue that hot shooting from beyond the arc, so we shall see if the Lions want to rely on those long 3 balls for the rest of the game, or if they want to move it around a little bit more to share the ball with some of the other scorers, like Justin Wagner, who has 6, while Eric Lynch, Jeremy Wagner, Corey Doran, and Alex Jarman have tallied buckets as well. 13 minutes until we hit the court once again. The players are taking a break. We will do the same. Stick around, folks. We've got plenty more basketball coming up. UMass Boston leads Eastern Nazarene 42-33 in the championship round of the 30th annual Harbor Invitational right here on the Beacon's Broadcast Network. A matter of moments away from tip-off of half number two. Figuratively speaking, of course, the possession arrow pointing towards UMass Boston's end. They've got a 42-33 advantage with 20 minutes to go. And that's all that's separating them from a 5-0 start and a title in the 30th annual Harbor Invitational. Welcome back, folks. Thanks for sticking around. My name's Tyler Murray. We've got Charles Lye, the cameraman to my right, and Jose Pena, bringing the Pena, here today on our directors for the streamcast. He's taking care of business as Medina will take possession. The Beacons shot 50% from downtown in the first half, 7 for 14, including 2 from Carl Joseph and 2 from Carl Aganor. There is Joseph finding Ulysses. Same starting 5 for the Beacons to open up half number 2. McGuire, a turnaround jump shot. That won't go. And the rebound goes to Alex Jarman. Now this is Jalen Owens, who had himself quite the first half. Can't continue his hot shooting, though, to open the second. Off the side rim and out of bounds. The Beacons lead by 9 here, a chance to extend. Owens hit 5 of 9 shots overall in the first half, 4 of 6 from beyond the arc, 14 total points, and 3 rebounds to go with it. Joseph kicks out to McGuire, thought about launching one from distance, but instead gets it back up top to Young. They swing it around to Ulysses. Nice bounce pass inside from McGuire. Lost the handle. Thought he got hit, but a clean play stripped away by Wagner and Owens. It'll be an inbounds below the basket for McGuire. Steven, the senior, bounces one inside to Young. Turnaround up and under, but traveling is the call. A tough one there on Gregory Young, but apparently didn't keep his pivot foot, and it goes back to ENC. Eastern Nazarene, located right nearby Boston in Quincy, Massachusetts, founded in 1900. Enrollment of just under 1,500 students. As a nice pass inside, frees up Jarman, and he puts it in off the window, eluding the pressure of Gregory Young. Jarman with 4 points now on 2 of 3 shooting, 4 rebounds and an assist in that first half. Young defended by the undersized Wagner, and he just powers his way to the basket, plus the foul. Gregory Young, nicely done. The Beacons get their first points of the half and a chance to extend the lead to 10 with this free throw. Young now with 9 points, his first free throw attempts of the day. He's shooting 58% from the charity stripe in 2014-15. Aganor comes in for McGuire. And the three-point play is converted by Gregory Young. Now has 10 points. He and Carl Aganor both at that same total. Tied for the team lead, and this man with the ball leads all scorers, as we said, with 16 points on 6 of 11 shooting. Jeremy Wagner, bounce pass inside towards Jarman. Turnaround hook shot, and he splashes that one through. Using his slight size advantage over Carl Aganor, but pretty much even up. But good elevation there to find some space. Now Joseph spins around, gets it back out. This is Young for 3 off the front rim, and it's rebounded by Wagner. Justin gets it up ahead towards Owens. Now he finds Jeremy defended by Young. Up ahead to Owens once again, defended by Ulysses. He works through that screen. Kick out to Wagner. This is Justin from the corner, and he puts another one through. Justin Wagner, 3 of 7 from beyond the arc. He's got 9 points, all of them coming from long range. This is a 5-point game, folks. ENC not going anywhere, 45-40. Medina, bounce pass inside. This is Aganor, low block, kicks out. Tries for a jumper, but it won't go. Joseph keeps it alive. Aganor wants to drive this time, and he gets rewarded with a foul. So 2 free throws coming up. Well, Aganor, we've seen him show some pretty impressive range with his jump shot so far this afternoon. As we said, in the first half, he knocked down 2 of 3 three-point attempts. Can't get the first free throw to go. Aganor with his first free throw attempt of the day. Overall, this season he's shooting 85% from the stripe, but that'll certainly take a hit with those 2 misses. Inside to Lynch, spins around. Nice pass for Owens, but Lynch traveled before he got the pass away. Lynch had 17 points yesterday on 7 for 16 shooting, but so far just 2 buckets. 4 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist for the junior. This is Ulysses, defended by Wagner. Left-hand dribble drive up and under, reverse layup. That's pretty stuff as Luke Ulysses gets the Beacons back up by 7. 10 points for him, so three different Beacons tied at that total. This is Lynch, turned away from the basket and kicks out for Owens. Spinning inside, now Eric Lynch gets the roll off the window and one. Certainly showing up strong thus far in half number two. 6 points, a chance for 7, and more importantly for his team, a free throw here makes it a 4-point game. Not this time, though. Aganor gets the rebound. He had 10 boards in the first half and 12 overall now. Offensive foul called away from the ball on Carl Joseph. He can't believe it, but Owens hit the deck. Either a good flop or took a big hit there from Carl Joseph, who's smiling his way back to the defensive end. Neither team was in the bonus in the first half, but already two team fouls apiece with 16 and a half minutes to go in regulation. Down on the low block, this is a turnaround jumper from Jarman, but he can't get that one to go. Rebound taken by UMass Boston. Medina gets stripped. Here comes Jeremy Wagner racing with Ulysses. Wagner sends it to his brother Justin from distance. That's a chance for a 4-point play. He got fouled by Medina. And yet again, Wagner showing the long-distance efficiency. He's got 12 points, 4 of 8 from downtown, and a free throw here makes it a 1-point game. Couple of subs as Medina and Joseph exit in favor of Benavice and Omerovic. They got a good game here in the Harbor Invitational Final. Eddie Ramirez will come in now for Alex Jarman, who's out there with a couple of Wagners. Jalen Owens and Eric Lynch. 13 points now for Justin Wagner. He played 35 minutes yesterday in the win over Colby, but got just 6 points. Clearly stepped up his offensive game in this final round. 1-point game, 47-46. Whistle blows, a foul off the ball on ENC. It's a holding penalty, or foul rather. That's Eric Lynch who gets whistled for the foul. His third and the team's third, so two more and Lynch will have to leave for good, so he takes a quick seat on the bench. As the ball gets inbounded, Young, a pump fake, dribble drive, bounce pass to Omerovic, gets it back out to Benavice, all the way to the other wing for Ulysses. Double team down low as Aganor finds some space, wants to force it, couldn't get it to go, and a good rebound by Ramirez. Decent move inside by Aganor, but just too many lines down there to find a free shot. Owens pump fakes, Ramirez down low, got fouled by Aganor, and Eddie Ramirez with two free throws can give the Lions a lead. There were four different tie scores in the first half. The lead changed three different times. Timeout called by UMass Boston. Eastern Nazarene led by as many as 5 points. That was in the first 2 minutes of the game. The Beacons led by 11 with 5 minutes to go in the first half. But now, with a chance to give the Lions a lead, Eddie Ramirez has a couple of free throws to think about. We'll take a quick break, and we'll come right on back. 15:39 to go in the second. It's a 1-point game on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Both of these teams enter today's game averaging over 84 points a game, and we're seeing why. Very efficient shooting. Eastern Nazarene shooting 47% overall and 52% from long range, 9 for 17 three-pointers. And UMass Boston shooting 46% overall and 7 for 15 from downtown. That's a 46.7% clip. Free throw number one for Eddie Ramirez. We got a tie game. He's shooting 50% from the line so far this season. A chance to give his team their first lead since midway through the first half. He does just that. 48-47. The Beacons all of a sudden trail by one. Went into the locker room with a 9-point lead at half. We saw a 10-0 run from the Beacons in the first half as Ulysses throws up a wild hook shot off the front rim. Wagner comes away with it and draws a foul. Ulysses and Young were in on a double team, but Young gets whistled for a push. That's five fouls already on the Beacons. And just the first foul against Gregory Young, but two more fouls, and that'll be a free throw parade for ENC the rest of the way. Owens thought about it, finds some space. Nice pass inside. Jarlin takes a hit. Couldn't finish, but two free throws upcoming. Six fouls on UMass Boston now. First foul on Amerovich. Jarman shooting 54% from the stripe this year. 13 points, 9 rebounds, 5 blocks yesterday. Gets the roll here. It's a 2-point lead for ENC. Jarman, 6 first half points on 3 of 5 shooting. 5 rebounds to lead his team in that department as well. He goes 2 for 2 from the line. Jarman missed his first free throw attempt on an and one opportunity in the first half, but 2 for 3 now from the line. Some full court pressure being put on here. At least that's the way it seemed. But Ulysses will take it up, gets it back to Aganor. 3 points separating these two teams as Carl winds and fires off the front rim, and it goes to ENC. That one's picked up by Wagner, who finds Owens. 15 minutes to go. Owens gets inside, a kick out. This is Wagner again. Justin's knocked down 4 threes already. Maybe number 5. Nope, not this time. Off the front rim, and Young pulls down the board. Ulysses ahead to Benavicha. Omar slows down, but Young is open. Instead, he'll find Ulysses. Benavicha drives baseline left hand to the free throw line for Joseph. Carl is too short. He goes down hard, thought he got fouled, but a good rebound from Aganor forces a foul against ENC down low. That time it was Jeremy Wagner who got whistled. 4 team fouls against ENC. The Beacons pretty much in the penalty. One more foul, and it's going to be free throws the rest of the way for ENC as Joseph finds Benavicha. Ulysses with it to Aganor in the corner. He knocked down a couple of threes in the first half. Didn't want to try it there. Couple of 5'10 Wagner guards on Young, and he still loses the handle. Thought he got fouled, but apparently not. Ulysses over to the wing for Benavicha. Aganor down low, double teams, finds Ulysses. Good finish from Luke. Thought he got pushed, and the Beacons doing a little bit of talking to the officials here in the last couple of minutes. They trail by one as Ulysses gets another one. He's been very good inside today. We talked about his tough day yesterday, going just 1 for 9 from inside the three-point line as Young puts a hand on Jarman and gets called for a foul. But yes, Ulysses now has 12 points, a team high. Aganor and Young both have 10. As we said, the Lions are in the bonus, so a 1-1 coming up for Jarman. He just knocked down a pair a moment ago. The Lions have done well, I think, keeping tabs on Carl Joseph. 6 points so far. 2 of 5 shooting as Jarman puts it through and gets one more. Doran will come in to replace Eddie Ramirez. Joseph has knocked down a couple of threes, but those are his only baskets so far. Shows you that the Lions have done well to keep him out of the paint where he can be so dangerous. Joseph still with 3 rebounds and 2 assists thus far, although 3 fouls to his name as well. That could be something to watch down the stretch. 2-point lead for the Lions. This is Joseph working on Doran. His wild shot comes up short. Pass ahead to Owens. He runs it down, settles himself, and puts it in. Good breakaway speed there for Jalen Owens. He scores 22 points a game, had 20 last night, and now he's got 18 in his second game in as many days. Same story for UMass Boston. They played last night, defeated St. Joseph's College 85-76 after beating Fitchburg State on Tuesday 77-67. Joseph lost the handle, and now Jeremy Wagner gets it to his point guard, Jalen Owens. Largest lead so far for ENC was 5 points. It came in the first 5 minutes of the game. They're up by four, and they have the ball now. This is Doran driving on Joseph. A lot of contact there, but no foul and no basket for the Lions. And this is Ulysses. Aguinar picks it up. A timeout called by Charlie Titus. And they'll take a break. 53-49. Eastern Nazarene College has the lead with 12 minutes and 45 seconds to go here in half number two on the Beacons Broadcast Network. Stick around. It's been a battle of three-point bombers this afternoon. Just to give you an idea of how important the long-range play has been, UMass Boston has 7 3-point field goals and just 13 two-point field goals. Eastern Nazarene, even more drastic. They've had 10 buckets inside the line, but 9 3-pointers. See if these two teams can close out a little bit better as we hit the latter stages of today's game. It's been a good one. 53-49, Beacons trail. Aguinar forces one up, well short. Deflects off the hands of Christian Lynch, and it winds up with Alex Jarman, who gets it to his point guard, Owens. Down low, Doran finds some space. Good defense there, a good recovery by Joseph to trail him inside. And down goes Aguinar, got fouled from behind by Wagner, it looked like. It is five fouls on Eastern Nazarene. That foul is actually on Corey Doran. The Beacons already in the penalty. Two more fouls against ENC, and both teams will be shooting 1-1. Young gets a pick from Joseph, finds Ulysses, down low to Aguinar. Just single coverage this time, but now double help comes over. Aguinar off the back rim, and it's taken away by Jarman. This is Christian Lynch. Near side, Justin Wagner lost the handle, spins around and gets it back towards the center logo, where Owens will direct some traffic. Stephen McGuire is set to check back in. We talked about Wagner and his shooting ability already in this game. 4 for 9 from downtown. Didn't have enough room to launch one that time, though. 6 seconds on the shot clock. This is Owens, defended by the larger Ulysses. Finds space inside. Pretty move, but no finish. Shot clock went off, but the Beacons have possession. Play on. Medina and McGuire now set to come in for UMass Boston, while Jeremy Wagner heads to the scorer's table for ENC. Ulysses had space, but wanted to pass off. Young winds up with it. Hop step inside. Plants his feet. Off the window. No good. Fans wanted to travel, but they get the ball anyway, and there's a hip check put on by Gregory Young, who's a bit frustrated here. It'll be 1-1 at the free throw line for Jalen Owens. Clapping his hands after drawing that foul. And here come the subs, McGuire and Medina, in to replace Benabicha and Aguinar. After a very good first half shooting, Carl has been a little bit on the downside here in half number two. 4 for 11 overall. After he went 4 for 6 in the first, so easy math, he's 0 for 5 in half number 2. as Owens puts this one home. 54-49, ENC with the lead. Owens goes 1-for-2. He's got a game-high 19 points. He scored 20 yesterday, played all 40 minutes, and has not been taken out yet in this one. Beacons trail by six, their largest, or five rather, tie for the largest deficit of the game. Joseph gets blocked, stays with it, loose ball knocked around. Joseph gets down and dirty, keeps it alive for a teammate. That's Young, or I beg your pardon, Medina just into the game. Looked like he got there first, almost like a couple of football players diving for the ball, but it's going to go to ENC. Jump ball was the call. The possession arrow points towards the Lions. As we get our first look at Sam Freeman today. Freeman coming in for Young. Sam, the sophomore from Boston, Mass., got his first points of the season with a first-half putback last night against St. Joseph's College. Beacons down by five, about halfway through this second half. Now Lynch dribbles with the left hand. He finds Jeremy Wagner. Can't get the roll. Ball bounced out of bounds. Looked like it was off of Ulysses. ENC keeps possession. Eddie Ramirez comes in for Doran. Jarman had room, but gets it back to Owens instead. He'll re-enter the pass. Jarman had it taken away, but it rolls right to Owens. Defended by Ulysses. Right-hand dribble drive. Pump fake. Now he gets it to Lynch. Defended by McGuire. Left-hand drive. He gets the scoop shot to go. Not an easy finish. He made it look pretty simple, but a tough shot. And a seven-point lead, biggest of the day for Eastern Nazarene. Medina down to Freeman. Couple of big bodies going at it. He turns away from Ramirez, but in and out. A smooth move that time from Sam Freeman, but some misfortune on the rim. Down low for Ramirez. A good job by Freeman to force him away from the paint. Lynch gets the deflection. Pass through the paint, knocked away. Medina comes up with it, still scrambling for it, but he got back to his feet. That's a travel. Far side official right on top of it. We're going to get a substitution as Ivan Cutts Jr. comes in for the first time today. He's also a Boston native, playing in his senior season for Charlie Titus. And a sub as well for ENC. Eric Lynch will come in to replace Eddie Ramirez. Ramirez played just 7 minutes yesterday, but a lot more time here in game two of the Harbor Invitational. And the final round. Jarman, a nice spin move inside, but Freeman says no. A big block there. UMass Boston down by seven, looking to cut into the lead. Down low to Freeman, has the room and puts it in. Sam Freeman making an impact. We saw him yesterday have that putback that got the Beacon some much-needed life off the bench. And right now, Charlie Titus looks to keep Freeman in there as long as he can get this kind of energy. Lynch trying to back down Cutts. He finds Christian Lynch outside, and he knocks it down. Once again, the long-range shooting continues. 59-51, Beacons are behind. 8.5 minutes to go in the second half. This is Medina. Freeman wants to try it again. Hop step in the middle. Baby hook, and it's good. Sam Freeman, the only shot he missed, rattled in and out. They're feeding the hot hand now. Down by six. Owens defended by Ulysses. Lynch finds Wagner. Medina's right there. 15 to shoot. Owens defended by Ulysses again. Not much movement yet from ENC. Now they get a pick from Jarman. Freeman doesn't want to switch, but he has to, but works hard to recover and gets a deflection and a steal. Sam Freeman making a difference, but the Beacons give it right back. Medina pass behind Joseph. You could see why Owens did well to hustle back and force the tough pass. And Joseph could not adjust. Under 8 minutes to go. 6-point game. Medina has to switch over to Owens. Near the elbow, this is Lynch. Gets a pick, works around Cutts, but Medina helps out nicely. Owens has room from three. He puts it home. A little conversation between Cutts, Ulysses, and Owens. Good competition out here. Cutts tried to answer, but he stepped before he dribbled. That's a travel. Biggest lead of the day for ENC. They lead by 9, 62-53. And a full timeout called by Charlie Titus. UMass Boston wants to talk it over as the Lions faithful make some noise down below us at Clark Athletic Center Arena. Quick break. Back with more basketball. This is the Beacons Broadcast Network. Back live in Boston, Tyler Murray, Jose Pena, Charles Lai, the crew this afternoon. It's been a back-and-forth battle in the final matchup and round of the Harbor Invitational, the 30th annual Harbor Invitational here on the campus of UMass Boston. 62-53, ENC has the lead, and the man with the ball is a big reason why. 22 points from Jalen Owens, 5-for-7 from downtown. Defended by Ulysses, and he traveled with it. Luke wanted that ball right away, but the referee's got to touch it first, of course, as Ivan Cutts Jr. passes inbounds to Leo Medina. Gregory Young is set to check back in at the next whistle, and Medina throws another one away. Here comes Young. There goes Cutts. It'll be Joseph, Freeman, Ulysses, Medina, and Young out there with Justin and Jeremy Wagner on the court for ENC. Along with Owens, Lynch, and Jarman. Eric Lynch, to be exact. Justin Wagner, defended by Gregory Young. To the elbow for Jarman, defended by Freeman. Back up top to Owens. A good battle between he and Ulysses so far this afternoon. Down low, Lynch gets away from Joseph. Left-handed layup won't go. And a foul called on Carl. And he's not going to like this one because that should be his fourth. Indeed it is. A big reason why Carl's been mostly silenced this afternoon. A tough call on Carl. As we said earlier, he's still stuck at 6 points. First free throw won't go. Lynch has 6 points so far. 0-for-2 on the afternoon from the free throw line. But 3-for-5 from the field. 0-for-3 on the day from the charity stripe. Beacons catch a break. But remember, one more foul on Carl Joseph and his day is done. Got the ball here. Kicks out to Medina. Now Ulysses, far side wing. That ball is kicked by Wagner. And with 6.5 minutes to go, the Beacons hang on to possession. They're in the double bonus. Any more fouls and it'll be 2 free throws for ENC. The Lions have just 5 team fouls. Medina down low to Young. No look pass. That's a pretty feed. And Greg finishes. A couple of ill-advised passes wound up out of bounds from Medina, but a good recovery there to get the Beacons back within 7. Young now has 12. That's his second bucket of the half. He spent plenty of time on the bench because he has 4 fouls. Nice move inside by Eric Lynch. A quick answer. It's back up to a 9-point lead. So both Young and Joseph, statistically, the Beacon's biggest producers, 1 foul away from having to lead the game. This is Young. He has Freeman down low, but instead he'll get a pick from Joseph. Gets the ball right back to him. Look at that size disadvantage for ENC, but instead Joseph swings it back around. Young inside, working hard, got hit, put it in. And the Beacons back within seven, 64-57. 14 points now for Young on 6 of 12 shooting. He's 1 for 4 from downtown. 4 rebounds, 3 assists to go with it. Jarman back inside to Lynch, defended by Joseph. He can't be too aggressive. A foul is called, plus 1. We'll see who they give that to. Joseph made zero contact with the shooter. The foul is called on Sam Freeman, and Joseph is headed toward the bench as if it was called on him, so we'll see if they change it. As the free throw from Lynch goes in and out. Yes, indeed, the foul on Freeman, his first, so Joseph gets to stay in. Medina inside to Joseph, has room, blocked away by Jarman, and back comes Owens. Beacons trail by 9, under 5 minutes to go. They cannot afford too many more empty possessions like that one. And quite obviously, they need some stops, but they've got two guys out there with 4 fouls. Swung around, this is Jeremy Wagner. That would have been big. Knocked away, back to Wagner. Ulysses was all the way down into his own end and couldn't pick up the tip. UMass Boston in dire straits here. 3:44 to go. Timeout called by UMass Boston. A quick 30-second timeout. We'll take a 30-second break ourselves and come back with more. 3:43 to go, a 9-point lead for ENC. Looking to take home the Harbor Invitational title here on the campus of UMass Boston. This is the Beacons Broadcast Network. Sixty-six-57, Lions lead it. 3:43 to go in the second half. Charlie Tettis sends out Medina, Ulysses, Young, Aganor, and Joseph. Remember, both Joseph and Young have 4 fouls, 1 more, and they're out of here. Plenty of time left. Ulysses defended by Wagner. Over to Joseph, towards Young in the corner. Thought about a baseline drive, but gets it back around to Medina. Leo leaves one for Ulysses. This is Joseph. Jab step left. Pass to the right. Medina gets inside. Hop step around. Jarman misses the lay-in, but gets the offensive rebound and whips it off the head of Owens, who takes it away. Near side, Justin Wagner in no hurry, and a wise decision there not to force one up. 3 minutes left, a 9-point lead. Yes, just a 3-possession game, and the Beacons have shot quite well from downtown in this one, but Right now, they haven't had too many open looks. Good defense down the stretch from Eastern Nazarene. 10 seconds to shoot. UMass Boston needs a stop here. Owens inside, a little floater, gets it to go. Biggest lead of the night. ENC 68, UMass Boston 57, an 11-point cushion. Young has to hurry, gets stripped down low by Wagner, dives for it, but Owens has the ball. Another bucket here in ENC could put the nail in the coffin. UMass Boston led by as many as 11 in the first half. They're down by 11 here with 2:20 to go. 15 seconds to shoot. Wagner goes to Wagner, Justin to Jeremy. Jeremy defended by Young. Beacons pressuring at first, but they do have just enough time to force a stop here and still be in it. Owen spins inside all the way in for Wagner, but they say no shot. The shot clock apparently expired, as the near side official adamantly says 35 seconds had already run off the clock. Big call there. The Beacons would have been down by 13 with 2 minutes left. Instead, it's an 11-point deficit. Not a lot's been going their way lately, but they get the call there. Joseph. Gregory Young gets a pick, bounce past Ulysses. He has three-point range but takes it inside. A foul on the floor. That'll be 16 fouls against Eastern Nazarene, so no free throws. The Beacons, though, have a fresh shot clock. That doesn't matter too much, as they'll be putting up as many shots as they can. Joseph pounds the ball inside to Aguinor. Nice finish to control himself in midair. That's his first field goal of the second half. He started 0 for 5 and rode the pine for a bit. 95 seconds to go. UMass Boston down by three possessions. Timeout call by ENC. UMass Boston was trying to trap there. There will be 22 seconds left on the shot clock. 1 minute and 27 seconds left on the game clock. The Beacons desperately need stops. They need 9 unanswered points. They do not have enough time to simply get 3 stops and get 3 scores. Of course, 35 seconds on the shot clock makes a big difference for ENC. It looks like maybe they'll go for a defensive stop here. Best case scenario, of course, is steal and a breakaway, but they're looking for a missed shot. Then they'll need to score quickly. And from that point, you will likely see them start to foul if they don't do it here. 68-59, UMass Boston trails. They'll stick with the same lineup except for Benebicha comes in for Medina. Full court pressure here. Benebicha nearly got a hand in, but Owens picks it up. Defended by Ulysses, 15 seconds to shoot. Over to Justin Wagner. Owens gets it back. Now Jeremy Wagner. Young nearly fouled there. That had been a waste of about 30 seconds as Wagner gets pressured, knocked away by Benavicha. 1 minute, 5 seconds to go. Omar inside, good finish, and it's back to a 7-point game. 1 minute to go. Now they need to foul here unless they can force a steal. Jarman nearly had it taken away by Joseph, and Ulysses got a fingertip on that one as ENC able to keep the ball away for the moment. The Beacons were hoping to put a trap on, but a foul called anyway. That's their 11th. So two free throws coming up for Eastern Nazarene. This is Justin Wagner, shooting so well from downtown in this game. On the season, he is 5 for 5 from the free throw line, so not good news for UMass Boston. He puts that one through off the back rim. Going to be a 3-possession game no matter what. The question is, 8 points or 9 points? 9-point lead with 50.4 seconds left. Ulysses ahead to Aguinor. Bounce pass to Joseph. He has Young in the corner, open 3-ball. That's a big one for UMass Boston. Back to a 2-possession game, 70-64, as Charlie Titus wants to talk things over. Clutch shooting there from Gregory Young, who had 6 points in the early going, 7 by halftime. And with that three-pointer, UMass Boston back within 2 possessions, but They're going to need to foul here and hope for a couple of misses to keep themselves back in it. A lot of good free throw shooters on this Eastern Nazarene team. Young now has 17 points to lead UMass Boston, if you're wondering. Jalen Owens has 24 points. Justin Wagner with 14 for ENC. And, of course, the issue for UMass Boston in this game, the Lions don't have any players with more than three fouls. Eric Lynch, the only one with three. Everybody else has two or less. But four fouls on Carl Joseph, four fouls on Gregory Young. Carl Aganor had a very cold start to the second half, 0 for his first five after putting up 10 points and 10 rebounds in the first half for yet another double-double. He had one last night. And that forced the hand of Charlie Tuttis. He took him out of the game in favor of Sam Freeman. So for a good chunk of time in the second half, the Beacons were playing without Aganor, without Young, and without Joseph. Three guys who have really carried this team on both ends of the court all season long, and Eastern Nazarene was able to take advantage. So you've got the Wagner twins out there. Jeremy, who will pass in, shooting just 62% from the line this year, but Justin, 7 for 7. Pass comes in to Christian Lynch, dribbles around a bit, up ahead to Justin. They don't want to foul him, but they have to with 38 seconds left on the clock. Christian Lynch hasn't had a ton of free throw experience this year, but the Beacons couldn't get a hand on him. We'll see what Justin Wagner can do from the line. So plenty of time left, relatively speaking. Wagner 3 for 4 from the line in this game. Knocks that one down and he's got 16 points. Eric Lynch comes into the game for Christian Lynch. Eric shooting just 46% from the stripe this year. Wagner goes 2 for 2 and the Beacons back down by 8. 35 seconds to go. Aganor finds Ulysses in the corner. Benabicha drives, kicks to Young. They've got Ulysses open, drives inside. Luke will finish strong with the right hand. ENC let him get through, didn't want to foul him. And the Beacons back within 6. 26.6 seconds left. Full court pressure put on. Owens flashes near side. Once again, Wagner finds the space, and he nearly threw it out of bounds. Jarman picks it up, and he's shooting just 50% from the line this year, so I think as good of a game that Justin Wagner has had today, a wild pass to one of your weaker free throw shooters, not his best decision, but the silver lining for ENC, it didn't go out of bounds. 1 and 2, they're up by 6 here. 22 seconds left, Jarman misses this one. Entered the game shooting 54% from the line. He has knocked down a couple today, though. 3 for 6 from the stripe overall, so right in line with his usual per-game average. 22 seconds left for the Beacons. Jarman 0 for 2. Two possession game still. Ulysses needs to hurry. 18 seconds to go. Aganor, top of the key. Why not? And he does not connect with anything. He had the distance for sure, but the old Y-axis let him down. 14 seconds left. And a couple of free throws will ice this one. Owens gets the ball up ahead towards Lynch. He's got two teammates to find. Bounce pass over to Wagner, and he'll go back to the line. All but over here. 7.9 seconds left. 72-66. A very impressive second half put together by ENC. Yes, we talked about the Beacons not being able to use Aganor, Joseph, or Young for the majority, or at least around half of that second stanza because of foul trouble, as Wagner puts this one through. I should play the hand you're dealt. It was 42-33 at halftime for UMass Boston as Wagner goes 2 for 2 once again. 8-point deficit. Aganor with the ball across the timeline. Joseph forces up a three off the back rim. Carl gets a hand on the rebound as the clock expires. And Eastern Nazarene College has won the 30th annual Harbor Invitational on the campus of UMass Boston. The Beacons had a 9-point lead heading into the locker room, but a big-time turnaround, nearly a 20-point swing after they hit the locker rooms, has given Eastern Nazarene its 7th win to start the season. The Lions 7-0 in 2014. UMass Boston takes its first loss of the year. 5-1, still a very impressive start for them with some big wins already in the non-conference schedule. They've got two more non-conference games, or beg your pardon, one more against MIT. That's on Tuesday. And then the conference schedule starts against Keene State on December 6th. And with tight games like this, needing to use a lot of their reserves, maybe a big learning experience for UMass Boston to see what they can do against the Little East as the season goes on. But congratulations to Eastern Nazarene, a great start to their season, and the Lions able to take home a Harbor Invitational Championship. They're going to announce an all-tournament team, MVP, and a lot more awards here. We'll try to patch you into the PA announcements as we'll have some players honored down on the court below us at Clark Athletic Center. So listen up, we're going to hand out some awards here after a very good Harbor Invitational. A great time had by all teams here on the campus of UMass Boston. Here's Dave Wahlberg and Seth Orensky looking to get things set up, but we'll give you some final stats now that we have a little bit of a window between the presentations. Jalen Owens followed up his 20-point performance yesterday with 24 points today to lead all scorers. 9 for 15 from the field. 5 three-pointers, only missed twice. After that, 6 rebounds and 5 assists. Wouldn't be surprised to see him win team and maybe tournament MVP. Justin Wagner played quite well, 19 points for him. 4 of 10 shooting, with all four of his field goals coming from beyond the arc. As for UMass Boston, Gregory Young had 17 points. Carl Aganor had 12. Luke Ulissi with 14. 6 for 9 shooting, very efficient. And the Beacons came up just a little bit short. Looks like 4 different Beacons are being honored here. Stephen McGuire, Gregory Young, Carl Joseph, and Luke Ulissi. We'll patch you in to give a listen to the presentation here. That was the Beacons captains receiving their runner-up trophy, so no individual awards have been given yet, as Eastern Nazarene is taking their championship trophy. A well-deserved honor for them. Down by 9 at halftime, they put on a 19-point swing. Honoring some players from the College of St. Joseph and Colby College. Carl Joseph has been named to the all-tournament team, being honored here. Joseph, the only 4-year member of the Beacons, and the only one averaging more than 10 points and 10 assists throughout his career. Greg Young, also a well-deserved all-conference team nomination. A senior as well. Told you had 18 points and 7 rebounds with 6 assists and 4 blocks last night. Justin Wagner selected to the all-conference or all-tournament team for Eastern Nazarene. Yesterday had 6 points, but today a big game, 19 points. No surprise, Jalen Owens has won the Most Outstanding Player Award for the Harbor Invitational. He played all 80 minutes of the 2 games his team played this weekend. 20 points yesterday, 24 today. He did all the little things right as well. 7 rebounds yesterday, 6 today. 5 assists in both games, 6 steals yesterday. Certainly made an impact on the floor in today's game as well. So a quick presentation there. Again, the Beacons have both Gregory Young and Carl Joseph honored as part of the all-tournament team. And for Eastern Nazarene, Justin Wagner, named a member of the all-tournament team. And the biggest honor goes to Jalen Owens, the most outstanding player. We'll take a quick break and come back with some final stats and wrap things up. Once again, the final score. Eastern Nazarene wins the Harbor Invitational with a 74-66 win over the hosting UMass Boston Beacons. Congratulations to the Lions. All right, folks, we'll wrap it up quickly for you. No post-game interview this afternoon. A 74-66 win for Eastern Nazarene, who improves to 7-0 this season. And you look at the second half breakdown, 41-24. Very impressive overall point total after halftime for the Lions. And the final team stats, Eastern Nazarene out-rebounded by 12, but still able to take advantage of that long period of time with no Joseph, Young, or Aganor. That was probably the difference, not just because they weren't playing against the cream of the Beacon's crop, just the fact that they took advantage of it. A lot of teams would not be able to do so, but the Lions, quite impressive with closing out this one. And from downtown, that was the story all game long. The Beacon started hot, 7 of their first 14, but you saw what happened in the second half. They made just one more in their next five tries, while Eastern Nazarene went 11 of 22 from downtown. That certainly was the difference. Looking ahead, folks, a lot to see for UMass Boston men's basketball. We talked about that big showdown at MIT in Cambridge on Tuesday. That should be a pretty exciting battle. I might make the trip myself to the Rock, is what they call it, at 7 p.m., or the Roof maybe. I haven't been there in a couple years. But then on Saturday, Keene State will host the Beacons to open up conference play in the Little East, and then one non-conference game against Pine Manor, and then back to conference play against Rhode Island College. Rick comes to town on Saturday, December 13th. Well, let's thank our staff today. A wonderful job they were able to do. Seth Lorensky is our producer. Dave Wahlberg handling all the statistics. Charles Lai, the cameraman this afternoon, with the one and only Jose Pena, doing a tremendous job, as usual, directing traffic and making sure all the graphics are up to speed and looking good here on the Beacons Broadcast Network. That'll do it for us from Beacons, or from Clark Athletic Arena on the campus of UMass Boston. Don't forget, women's hockey still going on. They're just underway, in fact, against Colby College over at Beacons Ice Arena. For all of us here on the campus of UMass Boston, my name's Tyler Murray, saying thanks for listening and enjoy the rest of your Thanksgiving weekend.